Well, the going is very strong, I must say, for the Nifty and the Midcap Index right now. So high point of trade, 9863 is where we're at. 3.5% higher and a triple century, as Mangalam was referring to it earlier. In the mid-cap space, a lot of stocks are buzzing around. In fact, Bharat Forge is now up 12%. Federal Bank is up almost about 10-odd%. And something like an M&M Finance is also up about 6-odd%. So that whole space, autos, auto ancillaries and financiers are all doing pretty well. But everyone is just waiting to hear about any kind of drug or vaccine to do with the COVID-19 outbreak. We have the management of Hester Biosciences who joins in now, Rajiv Gandhi. He's going to speak about how IIT Guwahati and Hester have collaborated or are going to collaborate to work on a vaccine for COVID-19. And that's something that the street is eagerly waiting for. Rajiv, thanks so much for being with us. Can you tell us a little bit about this tie-up with IIT Guwahati for the vaccine? Where has work reached so far? And how long will it realistically take before a vaccine comes on board?
As you are aware, Hester has tied up with IIT Guwahati. The genesis of this tie-up was that we have been working with IIT Guwahati for more than a year on other animal vaccines, and they had already done some work on the COVID-19 human vaccine, and that is how it happened that we discussed and we decided to work together. So as things stand right now, they have already taken the work up to the next level, wherein they would be constructing the virus. And after the virus is constructed, it would be given to us, on which we shall then make a trial batch, do the animal trials, and then take the human trials. So that is where we are at this point of time.
Okay, so if you can give us any kind of realistic timeline on how long the human trials would take, are we looking at 3 months, are we looking at 6 months, and how do you plan to fund this entire process?
In terms of timeline, what we have committed that our animal trials would start by the end of the year. This is sort of an extended timeline that we have mentioned, but we hope to start it a little bit before that. In terms of human trials, at this point of time, it would be difficult for me to give a timeline. We are working, we are talking with the drug authorities itself, and we are trying to understand the process on how to take these, the vaccine for COVID-19 ahead. Normally, as you would be aware, a vaccine takes quite a few years, but the Indian government and world over, they are looking at how soon can companies develop it and take it further. So we are just talking on it, and it would not be appropriate for me to give a timeline point of time.
Well, Mr. Gandhi, while it is not appropriate for you to give the timeline of the same, if you could explain to me the rationale behind going ahead and telling the exchanges that you've done this and not saying that perhaps the timeline is, it's difficult to calculate how long it will take, or even give a sense of clarity to the exchanges. Because what happened yesterday was, after this announcement that you made, we saw a big surge on the stock price. So maybe some believe that you're pretty close to, cracking something. That hasn't happened. Why weren't you very clear in the communication that you made to the exchanges at that point itself?
To address that issue, we have been as clear as possible in our press note. And if you are looking at, this is an R&D project, and this is in R&D stage with most of the companies that are doing it, out of 70 companies that are doing it, we are nothing different. I don't think anybody has committed a firm timeline except one or two probably. And it would, while things are moving fast at our end, let one or two months go, and then we can probably give a little bit of a better time in a commitment. It's not that we are far. It's not that we are saying that it'll take 2 years, 3 years, 4 years. That's also not that we are saying at this point of time. Let each process give its result, and then we can give you a precise timeline. I don't think so. We have even been non-committal or anything of that sort.
Right. If you could tell us about your, you know, experience with human vaccines in the past, what have you done in terms of vaccines for humans?
We have been an animal vaccine company, and we have been producing vaccines for now more than 20 years, and we have been producing vaccines from all the processes from which even human vaccines are manufactured. So we have the technical capability to produce a vaccine, whether it is a human vaccine or an animal vaccine. There is no different standard for a human vaccine or an animal vaccine except for the testing time and the release, which is of a regulatory nature. So we have the expertise to make vaccines. There is no past.
So in terms of either technology
vaccine.
Or...
Yes.
So in terms of technology or R&D or cost, you won't have to make any additional expenditure?
No, we will, of course, have to make additional expenditure. We are ready with the financial planning internally, which we would unfold in the next 1 or 2 months. And we are absolutely ready. If you see, we have also taken permission to raise finances at Aster Biosciences. So everything is in place. But we would want to mention it at an appropriate time, which then at that time, you know, we do not delay, or then we don't give any date which we are not able to keep.
Okay, so, you know, just one final question, because everyone's eagerly awaiting some drug or some vaccine to do with COVID. I know it's difficult for you to give a timeline, but given how you have been a part of these processes in the past, do you think one can realistically expect some vaccine in this calendar year itself?
In this calendar year, at least not from us. I would not be able to comment on others who have taken up this for manufacturing.
And finally, before we let you go, one question. A lot of people are worried about non-COVID-related business going down for them. So how's business been for you, especially for your animal business?
We are producing animal vaccines, and our sales have been low in this month. Our plant has been functional because we come under life-saving essential commodities being vaccines, which are needed for poultry, cattle. Our sales have been low, and we have been impacted, I think that's the way it is for all of us at this point of time. I think we would be touching approximately 70% of our target in this month.
All right, Mr. Gandhi, thanks a lot for joining in. Wish you good luck with finding the medicine and the vaccine for coronavirus, not just for your company, but for the world at large. But we'll stick with the pharma theme itself. Local and global pharma companies have given rise to hopes of finding a cure for coronavirus. Biocon plans to repurpose their psoriasis drug for COVID-19. Ekta joins in with more details. Ekta.
Yes, Biocon is in focus. The company, in fact, is looking to repurpose one of its existing biologic drugs for psoriasis, itolizumab, to treat COVID-19. Now, remember that this particular drug was licensed way back from Cuba, and in fact has now been used in Cuba for patients to treat COVID-19 and has shown positive results. Separately, Biocon is also looking at a drug called Cytostorb, which is used for sepsis, which may also help in reducing mortality. And the drug has been licensed again from the US, from a US company, and it was recently approved by the US FDA to treat COVID-19. The company is also looking to collaborate with US companies to develop vaccines. And separately, Syngene, which is basically Biocon's R&D arm, is looking to work on an antibody test as well as a PCR-based diagnostic test for COVID-19.
All right, Ekta, thanks a lot for that. So let's now listen into what Kiran Mazumdar Shaw had to say about the possibility of Biocon repurposing their drugs for the COVID-19 treatment, and also how the rest of the drug trials are underway.
Remdesivir has just reported some promising data, but it's not a magic bullet, as you know. We are joining this effort by repurposing our own itolizumab, which is a anti-CD6 antibody, which has been approved for psoriasis, but it also has a very good effect on the cytokine pathway, where it actually does, have an effect on down-regulating what we call as cytokines, and it has an anti-inflammatory effect. So the combination of the two is likely to help in dealing with the cytokine release and the inflammation that we see in COVID-19. At this point in time, I don't think patents are going to be enforced. You know, Gilead has already got a model of licensing, patents. I mean, licensing without a patent fee. So I think those kind of models have been used in the past in India, where many Hep C drugs, antiretrovirals have been produced by Indian companies for the developing world markets. And I would assume that the same would hold true if remdesivir is required.
All right, with that, we'll slip into a short break with the news that the Nifty is closing in on that 19,900 mark. Come back, we get chatting with Pritesh Mehta of US Securities. He will give us some trading strategies.